Ruthie, we were already connected. Ruthie Berman and her beloved Connie Kurtz are a pair of the strongest women to ever fight for LGBT rights. Sadly, I did not have the opportunity to interview Connie, but I'd like to dedicate this to her. Ruthie Berman grew up in Brownsville, Brooklyn, and was raised Orthodox. It was a very integrated area: Jewish, Italian, Polish, and African American. Ruthie was an only child who was raised by her bubby, her grandmother from Poland. Being an only child, Ruthie felt some loneliness, but that was fixed by her close friends. They were called the Aminom, the No Names. Ruthie had a favorite story about their time together.
When we were about 14 or 15, this group, teenage girls, got together and they called themselves, they had the name. My name was the Aminons, No Names. We had a green jacket, our names were monogrammed, and we volunteered to work at a day camp in the high school we went to. So there were these little kids. And one afternoon, because we were poor, three of us stole some pencils and paper so we'd have for school. We stole it. And I went home and I had dinner and I couldn't deal with it. So I said to them, I said, we have to go back and return it. What, are you crazy? Return it? They'll catch us. I said, we'll go back, we'll return it. So that night, after dinner, we went back to the high school. There was a guard. We snuck in. We returned the materials, and we heard him walking. And my friend Gloria, gratefully she's still alive, snuck into a locker room, a locker, one of these long, thin lockers. And Sylvia did the same. Gloria lost it in her pants. But we were never caught. That was really very exciting. We still remember.
Wow.
What's even more exciting is that six of us are getting together tomorrow for 4 days in Manhattan, and we're going to see Fiddler on the Roof in Yiddish.
That's
of course, that was my first language.
Oh, wow.
Was Yiddish. Otherwise, my grandparents
yeah.
did not speak English enough.
Justice was something Ruthie felt was needed in this world from an early age. During the first day of kindergarten, she sat next to a boy, Arthur. Arthur, at the end of class, tore up a picture Ruthie drew. In retaliation, Ruthie ripped Arthur's, but the teacher only saw Ruthie's act. Even learning that Ruthie was only doing what Arthur did to her, the teacher still punished only Ruthie. That was one of Ruthie's first memories of injustice, and there was more to come. Ruthie, in her words, was in a beautiful closet while living with Connie in her early years at the Contello Towers. Ruthie did not feel the need to leave that beautiful closet until Connie said, "You are not respecting the relationship." What happened after that? Ruthie came out and sued the Board of Education. Ruthie and Connie changed the rights for the entire LGBT community due to a fellow guidance counselor at the school in which she worked. That guidance counselor and his wife had a health plan, but Connie and Ruthie did not, because they were not married.
Yourself. I'll tell you how it started. Connie and I come together. I am a guidance counselor at the time, and next door to me is a colleague, a guidance counselor. And his wife has a health plan with him. And they have two health plans together that they can maneuver. And Connie had no health plan working for Sports Green. So I had to join a Jewish organization that would give her a health plan, but it was nothing. And I said, you know, let's see what I could do. Maybe we can sue. I'll get in touch with my union. Maybe we can do something about it. Because how much more together would be me? And marriage never came into my mind. Serendipity. Is that the word? Serendipity. You know, like at the same time, exactly at the same time, I get a call from Lambda Legal. Would we be part of a lawsuit suing the Board of Education for the health plan that they have? Well, of course. And we did it with two other couples. The other two couples did not want to be known. We didn't care. We got on Donahue, all kinds of stuff. And Lambda worked it. Evan Wolfson was one of the lawyers. Glick, who passed away, was one of the lawyers. And it took a number of years. And then one day, Evan Wolfson called us. We were at our timeshare in Pennsylvania. And he said, we're going to sign. I said, are you signing for retired people as well? He says, no, that's a good idea. I said, put in retired people. I wasn't retired at the time. And so this came to be. It was the beginning in New York City because the mayor at the time, forgot his name. Names are very difficult when you're past 80. And also had to remember all these names as a phys ed person. Remember every kid was, A1 is Alice, you know the gym they have. That's what we did. We had the beginning of what other states began to do, domestic partnership, even though domestic partnership meant that if you were straight and you were living with someone, but you wanted them to be, you could sign up as domestic partners. So we were helping the straight people too. I think we got allies from that. I know personally of stories when they found out it was Ruthie and Connie, and they were straight, they applauded us, they thanked us. I said, give money to Lambda.
Through Ruthie's eyes, we have evolved because now LGBT is not a dirty word. The hateful words that come towards this community are only used by bullies and those of ignorance. I asked Ruthie what is the most hateful thing she sees aimed towards the LGBT community.
Two. Goes together. They really go together. One is the bullying that's still prominent in the school system, in other places as well, in places that are public, and if they notice that you might be gay, there's bullying, that's horrible. And the other is how the elders are treated when they need services from the medical profession. And they're not treated well. And I could tell you stories, but I'm not at this moment. And those two things I will fight for while I'm still breathing.
Ruthie said, many people in my generation are not out. They don't give their time or money to help, not only to their generation, but to the young people. They need to know that it's okay to be yourself. It's okay to be proud.
What I don't like, this is what I have heard for all these years. Oh, Ruthie and Connie, you can do it. You're doing such a good job. Well, come on, join us. Open up your pocket. Your pocket is not deep, then give your heart. How's that?
Ruthie, we were already connected by Israel. Even in Jerusalem, the holiest city in the world, there is a gay bar. That just shows how far we have come.
My beloved, who passed away recently, Connie Kurtz, moved to Israel when we were good friends. Her family is still there. Her two children live there, and her family, she has, 14 grandchildren. And so far to date, what's today's date?
August 6th.
She has 26 great-grandchildren.
Wow.
So we have something in common, Israel.
Ruthie, you are the reason I keep coming back to Compass time after time. You are a part of the past, present, and future because you inspire everybody every day.